And ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Super Kick Network from the Midwest to the world, the home of independent wrestling. We are in our opening contest, starting things off hot here. Here he is making his way through the crowd. Not even coming through the curtain. And the fans here in South Bend are showing their appreciation for their local product, Diesel Troxy. Enjoying himself an adult beverage before this match. Trying to keep himself nice and loose there. Not sure if he is legally able to do so according to the athletic commission, excuse me. But this is professional wrestling and anything is legal. Well, depending on the rules anyway. Representing one of my favorite comedies there too, with the Kenny Powers jersey. Shout out there. Referee trying to get the beer from Troxy. Troxy being responsible and not giving the underage referee a drink. See the fans here in South Bend, not a big fan of Jason Levi. Jason Levi going about 290 pounds at the weigh-in for this event. Meaning he has a 65-pound weight advantage over Diesel Troxy. I don't think that is going to deter Diesel one bit. Explaining to the referee that he cannot hold his beer. He was going to let the referee hold his beer, but the man cannot hold his beer as he is not 21. We are being responsible here at the Super Kick Network and deterring underage drinking. And Jason Levi deterring drinking altogether with that bottle of water. And that is just not safe in this day and age. Misses with the forearm, though, and Diesel just dropping in forearms of his own. There is an Irish whip off the ropes and a big big shoulder block, and Jason Levi running to the outside right now, trying to get his wits back about him. He was not prepared for the onslaught he got after spitting in his opponent's face. And really, that's on him. If you're going to spit in the man's face, you better be ready for what comes after it. Jason Levi clearly was not. And Levi leaving the ringside area now. And Diesel not having any of it. He is going back to the locker room himself. Diesel not coming through the curtain earlier. He is coming through the curtain now, and he is not coming alone. And a big avalanche into the corner. Irish Whip sends Levi across, and you could see the impact he hit that corner with. And a big avalanche there. Follows it up with a flying shoulder block. And the head might be the hardest part of that man's body, and it only gets a two count. Jason Levi with a little underhanded tactic there, but if you were going to wear baggy gear like that into the ring, you have to be prepared for it to get grabbed on. And Jason Levi taking advantage of everything he can right now, choking the ever-loving life out of his opponent there, and you can see Diesel feeling the effects. Levi taking issue with some of the fans here in South Bend. Rushing forearm against the chest. That one right across the temple. And Diesel is on Dream Street right now. He probably has no idea where he is. And Jason Levi might be telling Diesel that he's effing out right now. And if he wasn't before, he's choking him out right now. Again, referee counting. Levi breaking before the five. Bending but not breaking the rules right now is Jason Levi, using them to his full advantage and using the biggest weapon in the venue, with that being the ring. Diesel somehow able to kick out at two, using that tenacity that he is well known for. Forearm across the chin, keeping Diesel down. Jason Levi just grinding away right now. And now a shin to the chin and head of his opponent. That is nearly 300 pounds coming down. And those are just insulting. Traxie back on his feet now. Shot to the midsection. The crowd here in South Bend strongly behind him and loving it. Forearm to the temple. Tried to go off the ropes. Levi not having it though. Went for the choke slam. Traxie saw coming, but did not see that enziguri coming. Cover. Two. Diesel able to kick out into a full mount position, trying to choke the life out of his opponent again. A half mount, excuse me. Levi taking issue with the referee here before the double thrust chop to the neck, to the throat rather. And again admonishing the referee, you cannot worry about what the referee is doing in a match, you can only worry about your opponent. Big headbutt right there. Probably ill-advised, as I said earlier. That is the hardest part of Diesel's body. And something that he uses for offense quite often, and is not something you should be attacking. Sizing him up in a big savant kick. Sent Diesel lumbering down to the mat. Cover. Two. Two count only. Levi a little slow getting to the cover. That could have given Diesel the opening he needed. And a knee to the spine there. The knee and the shin. Hitting pretty much the entire spine of his opponent there. Levi doing what he can to gain the advantage here. And every time Diesel has tried to fight back, Levi has had an answer. Taking him down to the mat right now. The fans here in South Bend. Trying to give the man the momentum he needs. Trying to get behind Diesel. Levi admonishing the crowd, telling them that that never works for anyone. History might prove him differently. Trying to go up the third time. Didn't even need to be dropped. Didn't even need to be lifted. You could tell that Diesel was back with us in the land of the living as he is fighting back to his feet right now. Up on his feet, elbow to the midsection, elbow to the chest, follows it up with a second one. Closed fist to the temple, another one to the jaw, two to the jaw. And a big forearm sends Levi down. Trying to follow it up with a body slam. 300 pounds of Levi says no. Almost a shining wizard there. And Diesel is out. Cover once again. Excuse me, rolling him into the ring. Cover, two. Able to kick out. Great ring awareness from Levi to drag his opponent away from the rope, but it may have given Diesel the opening he needed to kick out. Great ring positioning by both men and veteran savviness. Levi slamming Diesel's head into the turnbuckle. There might be padding around that steel, but it is not very forgiving either way. And now he's looking like he may be trying to literally hang a man, maybe internally decapitate him. And Diesel doing what he can, trying to fight out, using the power he has. Taking Levi down, one, two. Levi able to kick out. Both men back to their feet now. And able to body slam the big 300 pounder. Here's a cover, two, three. Excuse me, that was a falcon arrow. And there you see your winner, Diesel Troxie. A hard-fought match from him. Levi in the driver's seat most of the time, just taking the fight and the match to him, but he was able to persevere and get the victory. And a huge one for the Rat Pack here in South Bend. The local boy coming through. And we will be back with more action in just a moment. And our action here on the Super Kick Network continues. And this another man who can qualify and call himself as a Haas. 285 pounds. And the fans here in South Bend showing their lack of appreciation for the man from St. Joseph's, Michigan. Literally telling the man that they will whip his ass. I do not recommend anyone getting in the ring with either of these men, anyone on the roster, really. Zero already having to defend his hometown here to the faithful fans in South Bend, Indiana. And the bell is rung. We are underway here. JJ Castillo clearly the favorite here, at least amongst the fans. TK Zero trying to gain some fans, not very successful right now. I think the fans here know who they're chanting for, and they know it's not TK Zero. And again, all the momentum clearly behind Castillo from this crowd here. Collar and elbow tie up. Castillo clearly going to have the power advantage here with the 60-pound weight advantage as well, but Zero showing he is no slouch. But Castillo again using the power and leverage from the lower center of gravity he has. And Zero very frustrated here in the early going. And Castillo just enjoying the frustration and playing mind games with Zero right now. Zero trying to get his head back on straight. Collar and elbow tie up once again, and this time using his leverage and a low center of gravity to push Castillo back. But again, Castillo too much power. Zero trying to reverse, but again Castillo just sends Zero into the corner. TK Zero trying to gain his win back. And TK Zero again taking issue with the fans here. Has to worry about the man in the ring, not the fans outside the ring. Again, another test of strength won by Castillo. Zero trying to power his way out of it. Thus far successful. Castillo doing what he can to fight it, but unsuccessful. And Zero has Castillo up against the ropes, though not with the kind of an impact that Castillo has been sending him. And a big, big slap to the face there from Castillo. Irish Whip sending him across the ring. Huge avalanche right there from Castillo. Off the ropes again, looking for another one, and a forearm smash. Off the ropes and a single leg dropkick. Basement dropkick right to the temple of Zero, only good for a one count. Going to take a little bit more punishment to keep either one of these men down. But that was still a smart pin attempt. Draining the energy there. And TK Zero showing the best way to keep a big man down is to chop him off at the base. And he is going after that knee right now. Quite intently. And again, focusing on that leg. Looks like he could be setting up. Looks like he might be trying for a variation on the Indian deathlock or the figure four right there. Has the shoulders down. Telling the referee to count. Has the shoulders down again. A series of one counts right now. Castillo doing what he can to reach the ropes and keep this match going, and finally reaches the ropes there. The fans here in South Bend giving him the momentum and the strength and perseverance he needed to reach that rope. And Zero again just destroying and punishing the knee of JJ Castillo right there. Castillo trying to fight back, trying to get a base back. You could see the left knee continuing to give up and give out every time he gets back up to his feet. And it's giving Zero the advantage he needs right now. And again, focused on that left knee, putting all 220 pounds on that knee. And you can hear Castillo screaming in pain with the weight on his ankle and knee. You can just feel the ligaments tearing. And the knee is not supposed to flex that way. And Zero dropping again. Here's the cover. Castillo able to kick out. You can see the pain etched across his face, though. Know that the damage has already been done. Castillo somehow able to fight back, though. Trying to put as much weight on that right leg as possible. That left knee is still definitely tender, as you could see right there. Him definitely feeling the effects of that. He has no power. And TK Zero again kicking that left knee out from under Castillo. And again putting him in the driver's seat and quelling that uprising. And wrapping it around the bottom rope right now, you can hear Castillo screaming in pain. Breaking the hold at four before he gets disqualified, however. And now wrenching it around the ring post, referee up to four, and again, Zero breaking the hold. Fans here letting Zero know that he cheated. He got away with it, though. He bent the rules. He did not break any of them, breaking the hold at four. And Zero taking issue with our official heel. Official here. Big forearm right now. You could hear the thud when it hit the jaw. and answers with another. Castillo, not feeling the effects though, answers with a forearm of his own. TK0 going on the attack. Lucha bypass from Castillo. Into the big Samoan drop there, trying to slap some feeling and some life back into that left knee, trying to get at least a little bit of adrenaline here. That could give him the opening he needs. Zero, some would say smartly though, rolling to the outside. Castillo not giving him any quarter or breather, following him right outside. Double axe handle right across the base of the neck, the top of the spine there. The lower C and higher T vertebra. And Zero sent crashing into the wall. And the referee has called for the bell. This is a double count out. Zero sent into the ring post. Here's the official announcement. And you could hear it right there, a double count out. TK Zero is left lying on the floor though. Laid out by JJ Castillo. And these two will definitely be seeing more of each other down the road. Nothing solved or finished here. Castillo pleading his case with the referee. Referee telling them they were both outside for a 10 count. Zero still feeling the effects. We will be back with more action after this. Both men taking issue with the referee's double count out. And we'll be back after this. It is main event time here on the Super Kick Network. The home of independent wrestling. His opponent in this main event, Blake Money Wright. Making his way here through the South Bend faithful. And ringing in the adulation here from South Bend. removing his money and handing it to the referee. There you see Mimic mind games already here, and this is a man that just scares the crap out of me. I'm not gonna lie, this man scares the ever-living crap out of me. Blake Wright is a braver man than I am here in the collar and elbow tie-up. Mimic has him up against the ropes here. Breaking at the three count. Just letting him know that he's that Mimic is stronger than him, at least here in the early going. Gets the waist lock locked in, but Wright able to work it into a headlock. Doing what he can to establish a wide base and really wrench it in. But leaving himself open for the reversal there from Mimic. And Mimic showing that as well as mind games, he can play the mat game as well. Has him in the wrist lock now. Wright able to roll out of it and turn it into a wrist lock of his own. Wrenching in the control now. Mimic doing what he can to get out of it, but feeling the effects of it here. But again, the wrestling acumen of both men on display here in the early going. Mimic trying to fight his way back to his feet. Money Wright still has the hold in though. But Mimic able to reverse it. As I stated earlier, both these men showing their wrestling acumen here in the early going. Big shoulder tackle there from Money Wright, sending Mimic to the mat, coming off the ropes now. Beautiful leapfrog there, but all for naught. And a series of arm drags. Hip tosses from Money Wright. Telling the referee to ask Mimic if he submits. You were not going to get the man to give up. No one home for the big strike. But there is someone there for those shoulder strikes to the corner. The old Cobra Kai adage showing itself to be true here. You cannot breathe, you cannot fight, you can only leave yourself open for a suplex. I may have added on that part about the suplex. The two count only Mimic able to kick out. Wright doing what he can to gain some momentum here from South Bend, but it gave Mimic the opening he needed to get out of the ring and avoid that offense. Wright yelling at the man he called a freak to get back into the ring. Now Mimic playing the mind games again, breaking the count up. Wright inviting him back into the ring, an invitation that Mimic does not want right now. But I think Wright knows it. Four. Referee up to seven now, again breaking up the count as Mimic draws right into his trap. You could see the hot shot right across the top rope. Shoulder tackle into the midsection there. Smartly keeping right in the ring though. Irish whip off the ropes into a back elbow. Here's the cover. This could be three, two. Right, able to kick out. Big knee there from Mimic. Here's the cover. One, two. Able to get the shoulder up. Referee a little out of position there, but was still able to see the shoulder come up. Mimic almost willing right back to his feet right now. He wants him on his feet, but I don't think he wanted those shots to the midsection. Money Wright fighting back, but a rake to the eyes from Mimic. Puts him right back in control, and again choking right out on the ropes, bending the rules, but again not breaking them, trying to take the air away from Money. Has him up in a fireman's carry now. Series of elbows from Wright, trying to get out of it. Able to do so, rolls him up. Two. Mimic able to kick out. Yakuza kick. Sends right to the mat. Here's the cover. Two. Wright able to kick out though, but only barely after that Yakuza kick. And now those are closed fists that he is just dropping down on Money Wright, raining rights. And the fans here at South Bend admonishing Mimic for that middle finger and for the blows he was dropping on to Jake Wright. Those closed fists, clearly illegal. Mimic does not care though. Has him a big, brutal backbreaker. And he keeps it locked in. Trying to get the submission here. Referee checking with Wright. Wright able to say no while screaming in pain, doing his best to fight back now. A series of forearms to the temple of Mimic, and Mimic finally breaks the hold. Wright doing what he can to fight back. The fans here in South Bend doing what they can to will him back to his feet. That neck breaker though, quelling that uprising. Wright able to kick out again, however. And Mimic again, going after the head and neck and air supply, really, of Blake Wright. And Blake Wright writhing and kicking, doing what he can to get the fans here behind him, doing what he can to get his own strength behind him to get back to his feet. The fans here in South Bend clearly behind Money Wright as they cheer him back up to his feet, give him the momentum he needs, a series of elbows, a knee to the midsection from Mimic. Cuts that off though. Avoids the clothesline. Oh my goodness! Money Wright able to counter. This could be the opening he needs, but both men are down right now. All Wright has to do is roll over. He's halfway there. Hook the leg, kid. He's sizing him up now for another lariat. Series of lariats now. Getting the faithful here in South Bend behind him before the stinger splash has him up. Sidewalk slam. Here's the cover, leg hook, two. Mimic able to kick out. Blake Wright sending tremors here throughout South Bend. He knows he has his opponent right where he wants him. Looks like he was trying to set him up in the Cobra Clutch. Mimic not having it. Backs his opponent into the turnbuckles. A beautiful back elbow there coming off the ropes. Double leg takedown by Wright. Two. Mimic able to kick out. And Wright wondering what he has to do to get the victory here. Everything he has thrown at Mimic, Mimic has been able to take. But to be fair, everything Mimic has thrown, Wright has been able to handle. Wright again going in for the kill. Mimic not letting it happen. Has him up in the fireman's carry. Into a cutter. Wright doing what he can to get back up. Leaves himself open though. Axe kick. That was a decapitator right there. Here's a cover. One, two, three. It was a hard-fought match from both men. In the end, though, that man, if you can call him that, able to gain the victory with the axe kick, honestly decapitated the man. We will be back next week with more action. We have championship matches next week for all of us here. We'll see you next time.